Conservation is one of the finest youth orchestras in the United States. And the reason for that is the reckless, bodacious devotion of Lee Stone, who spends every waking minute curating the miracle. So I hope you get a chance, you'll give her a hug and say thank you. Because I can tell you, this isn't automatic. This doesn't just happen. Someone has to make it happen. And we're very fortunate to have her. And then, a brief word for them. You know, they have very busy lives. They have survived so far COVID, which has wreaked havoc with the normal life of young people. And throughout the duration of this incredibly challenging time, they have stayed the course doing this. And I think if you ask them, they will tell you, there were many times when actually playing viola, playing double bass, playing timpani, playing violin, was a way to keep safe and centered while you had to weather the nightmare of what we all went through. So this wonderful orchestra has already developed an aspect of their personality and temperament they can use forever. So I'm just so thrilled to have been here for one day and a half and listened and watched how amazing it is that in this era where they're filled with noise and multitasking and everything's about speed, we have this sanctuary where quiet and nature are governing the lives of these people, and they live through music into the world in a way that's so deep and so rich they could never tell you why, even if you ask them. You have to do it. So anyway, the program, it starts with Poet and Peasant by Juan Supe. It's a wonderful, famous, old, classical evergreen. You'll love it. It's okay to tap your foot occasionally. It'll be fun. There's some beautiful songs, and there's a fantastic solo by this clown here. This wonderful cellist. And you too. It's you. Oh, okay. This orchestra is so good. I'm watching the rehearsal, and this wonderful young man is playing. And now I realize she's actually going to play it. It's so good. So extra special applause for her. Then first movement of Beethoven's First Symphony, which is not a piece for high school orchestra, but a coral reef it is. And finally, famous Barber Adagio for strings, which they just played, and they will, when you hear this, you will realize why they chose music. And I asked them, if we don't mind, this beautiful, heartbreaking piece we'd like to dedicate to the children of Ukraine. So without further ado, can I please introduce this fantastic, I could call him my student, but that's a misrepresentation. He's a colleague with better hair, all right? Please welcome my great friend, Jorge Padrón.
Thank you.
Sisters, and my poor parents had to divide their time by four. It's very hard. You have a dog, imagine that times like 50. I owe them everything. Thank you. But not all, only them, you all, because your kids are here. See, I already had all that planned out, so he already said it. But anyway, you all deserve a round of applause for what you do for your kids. They don't know it. They don't know the back and forth, the expenses. They don't. They think they know, but they don't. So for you all. And I want to thank, again, it's already been said, but I want to thank two of my dear colleagues, Dr. Lee Stone and Mr. Kenneth Torgerson. I was lucky to work with Kenneth at Palmetto High School. The most fun I ever had working there. And I mean that in a nice way. It was a really fun time. It was a tough time. And he was a person that invited a lot of levity in my world, in a world that was very stressful. He's a consummate musician and somebody that I admire immensely. And I cannot be overstated how much I owe to Lee Stone. She is truly an outstanding human being. Somebody that loves teaching in a way that I did not think was possible. I got to work with her when she was at Westminster Christian School a long time ago, and everything I do that has ever been successful is because of her. Anything that wasn't successful, not. So thank you, Mr. Torgerson and Dr. Stone, for everything.
Thank you.
Saying that the people I need to thank the most for tonight are them, because none of this works without them. And I want to stress something here. That's hard for them to do, but they can do it. It's totally possible. What is really hard is the Barber Adagio. It's not an easy piece. It asks a lot of people their age. It puts them in places and ask them to tap into emotions that they might not be super familiar with or might not be comfortable exploring. To me, it's a hymn to redemption amid sadness and sorrow. It's not so much about breaking up the clouds after the storm, but finding peace in the storm. And that's not always easy when you're 14 years old. So I want to thank them tonight, because they've proven to me that they can do it. Thank you.
todas maneras, esto es bueno para él. Lo que él quiere ver de los dos lados, como él estaba pensando, Connor lo tiene de allá para acá y tú lo tienes de aquí para allá.
Okay. on Monday, is that right? They're going to state on Monday? Break a leg. Thanks everybody for coming. I really appreciate it.
Son tres piezas. Yo no estaba esperando ver si...